Martin Hyde?
Indeed. If you want proof that Sarasota Democrats have made our city as blinded by partisanship and as incompetent as our Congress, you should all listen carefully now. Imagine an organization with annual revenues of over $250 million, which is around $21 million a month, or about $1 million per business day. Then ask yourself what financial records you'd want to see if you were sworn by oath to oversee it. Would you want to know if revenues and receivables were on track and on budget, and if so, how often? On the expense side, might you try to keep tabs on whether what was going out in terms of expense was in line with budgets? How long would a reasonable person go without knowing whether they were up or down in terms of budgeted expectations? Bear in mind, a month is over $21 million, as I said, so would you wait a whole month? What about 2 months? Surely you'd agree only someone truly reckless would wait a quarter of a year before a quarter of a year had passed, which will be over $62 million in and out, with the potential for the in to be less than the out, which is politely known as running a deficit, or less politely as going broke. I was going to ask you today if you knew how much revenues of Bobby Jones were behind budget, given that we're nearly 4 months into the financial year. I was also going to ask if you knew how much parking fines in Sarasota were running out over the first 3 months of the year, but there's no point, because you don't know. How do I know that you don't know? Ken, would you do the honors? How do I know that you don't know? Because the finance director wrote to me, as you can see here, to confirm that the city has not produced any management accounts or provided you with any figures since the end of last September, and that none of you has asked for any either. Yeah, on the parking fines, I know this isn't Q&A, so I'll say it rhetorically. Could any of you tell me how much the city is averaging in the last 3 months on parking violation? I can answer that. None of you, of course, would have a clue because none of you ever asked. Would it be as much, do you think, potentially as 10 grand a month in a city of 57,000 people? Would you believe me if I told you it averaged $56,000 per month? These are the city ledgers, which you've never asked for. Which is almost a dollar a month for every man, woman, and child in our city every month. The city is stealing over $672,000 a year from the local economy, often from those with the least ability to pay in parking fines. Why is this number up by 20% year over year? You can't answer the questions if you don't have the facts. Last week, I told you how much you were losing at Bobby Jones. You ignored me. I also told you how much you're wasting on legal expenses. And again, you ignored me. Thanks to the city finance director, we now know it's not just me that you ignore, but your entire fiduciary duty by allowing a city to run unchecked for a third of the year. You are, by the way, I believe, running a deficit, but there's no way for you to know, as you're willfully blind to the facts, because they're being brought to you by a Republican. Facts are facts, whoever brings them, and it remains your sworn oath to act upon them. Fortunately, we're in an election year, so we can hope the citizens will elect commissioners that actually take their duties seriously before we actually run out of money. Thank you.
Thank you.